Hi, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to see the PhD admission notification from the 44 CSIR research institutes. So it is a very good opportunity and a wonderful opportunity to the PhD aspirants. Why? Because doing the PhD in the research laboratories or the research institutes is far better than doing the PhD in the academic institutes. Why? Because if you did the PhD in the research institutes, you will get the very good practical knowledge, and there will be a wonderful opportunity in your future also. Okay, in the same research work, fine. So here the eligibility is a UG or PG. That means for the UG candidates, there is a integrated PhD, is there MTech plus PhD. And while coming to the postgraduate completed candidates, here you can go to the direct PhD admission, fine. So let us see the details regarding this notification. So before going into the main content of this video, here one announcement is that the candidates who are preparing for the UGC in December 2020 cycle exam. So from April 7th onwards, the revision through the previous year questions for the paper 1 as well as the electronic science. Okay, so utilize this opportunity, guys, and the details regarding this one I kept at the end of this video, and the links I kept in the description box of this video. Coming to the present content of the video, it is the ACSIR online admission portal. Okay, so it is the official website of this portal, guys, and here you may check down. The PhD for the engineering eligibility is the ME or MTech and a PhD in sciences. Okay, here you may observe the starting date and the last date to submit the online application form. That is 31st May 2021 for the engineering, and the same date is the last date for the PhD in sciences. The same for the integrated PhD, that is MTech as well as a PhD. So here the eligibility is a BE or BTech, and for the MSc and the MTech also the online applications are opened here. Okay. So you may check down carefully, guys, all these things, and here I will show you the ACSIR centers. Okay, so here the total 44 research institutes are there. So really it is a very good opportunity, guys. Utilize this one, then your future will be very bright and very colorful if you once did the PhD in the research institutes rather than the academic institutes. Okay, and here you may check down. Okay, which lab is offering the PhD in which departments, and what is the lab coordinator name? Okay, and the website's individual lab or else the research institute's website is also given here. So you may check down here. So what here the address is also there. So whatever the research institutes is nearer to you, then you just go to the official website of that one and check down. What is the current work going in that lab, and what are the different disciplines or the departments are there, and who are the persons working on that particular emerging technology or the emerging topic. So please go through all these things, and based upon that one, prepare one research proposal. Okay, and if possible, try to publish any one journal. Okay, based upon that research proposal. Okay, see, there's total 44 research institutes are there all over the India. So wonderful opportunity here it is if you once get the PhD in these research institutes. Okay, so always I will give the first preference to do the PhD in the research institutes other than the academic institutes. So utilize this opportunity, guys. Why? Because there will be a lot of drawbacks of doing the PhD in the academic institutes. Okay, there will be a lack of practical knowledge, and sometimes there will be a lack of software or else the tools whatever you require to finish your PhD. And even though the tools are there, okay, sometimes the PhD aspirants or the PhD pursuing candidates are facing difficultiness to know the tool, okay, how to deal with the tool. Okay, so a lot of difficulties are there, but in the research laboratories, the tool availability will be there, and you are doing your research work in the laboratory itself, so the lot of practical knowledge you will get. Okay, so these are the ACSIR centers, guys, and while coming to the remaining eligibility conditions that I will show you. Yeah. So here in the important instructions, so welcome to online admission portal. Okay, so online application and important dates I already shown you, and coming to the eligibility criteria of the PhD sciences and sponsored PhD sciences, candidates with master's degree in science or equivalent are eligible to apply. The candidate should be having the valid national level JRF, SRF of various funding agencies or any other equivalent fellowship like Inspire RG, ENF, etc. For the PhD in sciences. Okay. And while coming to the sponsored candidates with a master's degree in science or equivalent are eligible to apply. with endorsement from industry or academic or research institutes for acquired academic level and financial support during the program. Okay, and here the applicants qualifying their degree in percentage shall use the formula is mentioned here. And eligibility criteria for the PhD engineering and sponsored PhD engineering, a master's degree. Okay, following a 4 years engineering or technology, or else integrated M.Tech is also fine. Minimum of 5 years. And out of this one, at least one out of the A to E, at least one must be meet. Awarded a NET JRF at CSIR institutes, meeting all the conditions for the eligibility of CSIR SRF, meeting all the conditions award of Inspire Fellowship, and ACSIR for project assistant and ACSIR for industry sponsored students. Okay, and integrated M.Tech or PhD program, a 4 year undergraduate engineering or science. So at least one of the thing awarded NET JRF, okay, meeting all the eligibility conditions of CSIR gate JRF and Inspire, okay, project assistance to register for a PhD, and meeting all the conditions stipulated by SIR for industry sponsored students. Okay, so here these are only minimum quality yardsticks of eligibility for consideration of admission and bear no relation with financial assistance or scholarship. Any stipend or scholarship or financial source for study would be the sole responsibility of the student. ACSIR itself doesn't provide any scholarship or have any rules in these matters. That means here, who are the students want to take the admission in this one, in these research institutes, ACSIR is not going to provide any stipends. Okay, so if you are NET JRF qualified, either UGC or CSIR, then you will get from the corresponding agencies itself. So you won't get any stipend from the ACSIR. That's what they mentioned here. So these are the complete details, guys. And while coming to the fee structure, so comparing with the lot of academic institutions, the fee structure per semester or else annually, it is very, very low, guys. Okay, so coming to the full-time regular semester, 8,000 rupees, fine. So here the engineering and M.Tech and integrated programs, so the fee structures are also mentioned here. So please share this information to your friends or colleagues who are looking for such type of opportunities. And for more notifications, subscribe the channel and then tap the bell icon. And the candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET exam, here one announcement follows. So please listen, guys. Hi friends, my name is Ashwini Kumar, Unacademy educator. So all of you know that Unacademy is the India's largest learning platform, and it is providing the very good content to the learners who are preparing for the competitive examinations. And from this video, I want to bring you one notice that I'm going to start the two new courses for the UGC NET candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET exam in 2021. So the course number one is complete course for the NTA UGC NET paper 1, that is teaching and research aptitude. So that it is going to start from November 9th onwards. And coming to the paper 2 is electronic science. So the complete course for the electronic science is going to start from November 10th onwards. So the interested candidates may take the subscription plan of the Unacademy, that I will show you the different types of subscription plans. But before going to the to those subscription plans for the paper 1 and as well as to the paper 2, one thing that I want to share you is that if you want to check how the lectures will be, and why, because each and everybody is having some dilemma that before taking the subscription plans, that whatever the content I am going to teach you, so how the content I'm going to give you, so whether you can able to understand or not. So for that purpose, I will provide my Unacademy profile link in the description box of this video, guys. So if you click on that one, then you will be directed to this web page. So here, if you scroll down, you can check the special classes. So special classes means these are the completely free classes. So every month I'm going to take the free classes to the candidates. So if you click on this see all, then all my special classes that you can check down here, right? So if you click on these classes, then whatever the video classes I took at that date and time, so those videos will play. So with the help of these videos, you can decide that how I am going to deliver the content of the concepts and each and everything. So based upon that one, you may take the subscription plans, guys. Okay. And if you want to check that how I am going to teach the UGC NET paper 1, that is teaching and research aptitude, so it is my official YouTube channel link for the paper 1. that you can check down. I will provide this link also in the description box of this video. So here I did the complete unit one, that is the teaching aptitude here, by taking the total 6 parts. So it will be acts like the reference to you that how I am going to teach you, whether you can able to understand or not. So by looking all this content, that means the electronic science from the Unacademy app and from the YouTube channel, you can guess that how I am going to teach the paper one. So by looking all these things, you can decide.